the Controlled Environment Facility, or otherwise shortened to CEF, here at the University of California, Davis, is an important facility that serves a wide range of biologists, experimental scientists, and graduate students, undergraduates, etc. We're actually in the 20th year of our CEF operation, and since that time we've built two CEFs. This gives us a combined unit capacity of about 170 controlled environment units that cover all sorts of environmental conditions, from just regular day length and temperature to elevated CO2 or ozone. We have chambers that can give us down to about minus 20 degrees up to whatever temperature you want to cook your plants at. This range is necessary because we have a very large population of faculty that are working on all sorts of aspects of agricultural production, basic biology, through to elite lines that are being used out in the field. One of the most important challenges for the world is food security and energy, the cost of energy. And so we have faculty using the CEF facility that are looking at traits that are important for modern agriculture. Water use efficiency, crop yield under less than ideal conditions. We have people that are working on better ways to be able to go down the path of biofuels. Crop architecture that's giving you a better opportunity to improve the yield and be more efficient in terms of the fertilizer that's being used. One of the biggest problems in terms of agricultural production is going to be the availability of phosphate as a fertilizer. So when we're looking at phosphate, we're looking at the signaling between the roots and the shoots, and then from the shoot back down to the root. And to be able to dissect out the exact nature of the signals that are being transmitted through the vascular system to allow the plant to optimize its strategy to find the limited nutrient phosphate requires that we grow the plants under very highly controlled conditions. This is very difficult to do in a field. It's just as difficult to do in a greenhouse, but it's ideally performed in a growth room, because now we can turn on the light at exactly the same time. We can control the intensity. We can reduce the variability associated with our experimental output according to the biological rhythm rather than the perturbation, the stress that we're imposing. And we originally tried to do these in the greenhouse in my lab, and the noise was unacceptable in terms of being able to identify the reproducibility of the signals. So we shifted it to large chambers in the CEF. And now I'm happy to say we're getting really, really exciting results. Once we have identified the specific traits in wild plants, wild species, that have a much better ability to use phosphate, they can go through their life cycle with maybe 1/10 to 1/20 of the phosphate of a regular agricultural plant. These are the sort of things that we're interested in. How to identify these traits within our research environment here at UC Davis using the Controlled Environment Facility, and then going out and working with the agricultural biotech industry to be able to make sure that these traits get integrated into the different commodity lines that we're interested in. Without this facility, many of the grants, for example, that are awarded by the federal agencies couldn't be fulfilled. So the CEF is a fundamental facility and is recognized as being, you know, one of the best in the United States, if not the world.